John Paul II called the laity to the vocation of responsibility for the Church's life springing from the gift and mission of their baptism. In bestowing upon one Catholic couple each year the Christi Fidelis Award, Archbishop Gustavo recognizes persons who, in an extraordinary way, have demonstrated in their lives this personal and ministerial renewal. Celebramos hoy estos reconocimientos en la fiesta de la presentación del Señor, conmemorando la revelación en el templo de Cristo a su pueblo en espera. We celebrate these awards each year on the feast of the presentation of the Lord, commemorating the revelation of Christ in the temple to his expectant people. I am also excited to announce that with 151 parish recipients gathered here, this is once again one of our largest and most representative celebrations of the Lumen Gentium Awards. I would like to thank your pastors for their diligent work in gathering these nominations and for their appreciation of your meaningful ministry. In our prayer today, we will use the evening prayer of the Church's Liturgy of the Hours. The Liturgy of the Hours, also known as the Divine Office, is the daily prayer of the Church, marking the hours of each day and sanctifying the day with prayer. The hours are a meditative dialogue on the mystery of Christ, using scripture and prayer. In the hours, the royal priesthood of the baptized is exercised. And this sacrifice of praise is connected to the sacrifice of the Eucharist, both preparing for and flowing from the Mass. If you are not familiar with the format of evening prayer, you will find the instructions in your booklet helpful. The Archdiocesan Choir will lead us in the singing of the Psalms, and we will respond together, just as we respond to the responsorial song during Sunday Mass. For the presentation of the awards, we ask each pastor to escort his nominees down the center aisle to receive their award from the Archbishop when their names are called. We ask that all other guests or family members remain in their pew. A professional photographer will take pictures of each presentation, and we will mail a complimentary copy to each family following the ceremony. Para la presentación de los reconocimientos, pedimos que cada párroco acompañe a su recipiente por el pasillo central cuando escuche su nombre. Pedimos que los demás huéspedes permanezcan sentados. Un fotógrafo profesional documentará cada presentación. Mandaremos por correo la fotografía a cada familia. Nos preparemos. Un momento de silencio por nuestra oración y celebración. As we prepare ourselves for the moment of silence for our prayer and celebration tonight, I offer a word of gratitude for the kind and inspiring leadership of Archbishop Gustavo, who values and recognizes your missionary discipleship. We are truly a people encountering Christ, united as Church, and sent by the Spirit.
Thank you. Thank you. scepter of your power, the Lord will stretch forth from Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies. Power in the day. form of a slave, being born in the likeness of men. Jesus Christ is Lord.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
He was known to be of human estate, and it was thus that he humbled himself, obediently accepting even death on the cross. Jesus Christ is Lord.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
Because of this, God highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name above every other name.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
So that at Jesus' name every knee must bend in the heavens on the earth and under the earth, and every tongue proclaim to the glory of God.
De la carta a los Hebreos. No tenemos un sacerdote incapaz de compadecerse de nuestras debilidades. Al contrario, él mismo pasó por todas las pruebas a semejanza nuestra, fuera del pecado. Acerquémonos pues con seguridad y confianza a este trono de la gracia. Aquí alcanzaremos misericordia y hallaremos gracia para ser socorridos en el momento oportuno. El Señor revela su salvación.
El Señor revela su salvación.
Que presentó ante todos los pueblos.
Su salvación.
Gloria al Padre, y al Hijo, y al Espíritu Santo.
El Señor revela.
Each and every one of you is a living stone of the body of Christ, the church. Each and every one of you in your own vocation, with your own talents and gifts, what the Lord has given to you, you have been building up nourishes the body of Christ. It is a great joy to be in the midst and to see how the Lord is working in leading people to holiness in our church. This celebration is centered on the role of the laity, not that of honor. But we need one another, and I'm so grateful that our pastors are here to accompany you as a lay person to walk in the way of holiness. We gather to celebrate the light of faith that shines from those we honor with the Lumen Gentium and Christ Fidelity Leadership. Lumen Gentium, translated, means the light of the nations. And well, you have not been, strictly speaking, the light of the nations, but you have been the light of the world. And in that, you join the light of the nations. Christ Fidelis Leadership translates to Christ faithful people. And you, Ben and Veronica, for years in so many ways, you have been shown the fidelity of God in your own fidelity to one another, to the church, society of San Antonio. In doing so, you are also the light of the world. Both of these words affirm the laity's vital role and responsibility that springs from your own baptism, to listen to God's voice and respond. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. These members of our parishes, 151 throughout the archdiocese, have been nominated by their pastors for their great work, holy work on behalf of the communities of faith. I congratulate and thank all of them for their witness of Christian discipleship. Our reading from the letter to the Hebrews reminds us that Jesus, our high priest, was fully human as well as divine. So he understands our weaknesses, our temptations, our sufferings, our failures, our sins. He came into the world to proclaim the good news of God's mercy. He brought to us compassion and healing love for everyone without exception. The light of Christ is very much needed in the thick darkness of our world today. There is also darkness within the church. The issue of clerical sexual abuse has brought sadness, confusion, anger, and discouragement to us. We have been living in this darkness for 30 years or more, and it has continued to deepen. However, we are working hard to bring light and transparency as we try to bring healing and reconciliation to all those who have been affected by these sinful acts and illegal deeds. Jesus to be able to show himself as a light to the world, needed to come down, to be one with us, to walk with us, and to assume all our sinfulness and all the wrongdoings, because there are many things that they are not right, and not necessarily the sinfulness of people. It's just that our human nature is flawed. And if we add to our sinfulness, lack of holiness, then the picture looks very dark. And what a great hope with the presence of our Lord in our midst. And you being leaders of our churches, it's not because everything that you have seen is right, fine, beautiful, and great. Your community, and including in the leadership of the community, in our priests and deacons, and those lay people in leadership. But you have been able to read everything from God's perspective, thanks to our Lord who showed us the way. This afternoon, as you know, I express the darkness. In our church, or at least one very important element of that darkness, but also we express very clearly, and I convey on your behalf, that we are a better church today. And thanks to the work of many lay people like you in the church in the last decades. We say that we were very intense in the sorrowful mysteries earlier. We are the glorious mysteries now in you and through you. It is very clear that we all have to work together as the body of Christ to make the church safe for all of us, and not only about the sexual misalignments, but in many other ways, a healthier church. We need to acknowledge that we are the people of God, yes, but sinful people in constant need of conversion, reform, and renewal. Pope Francis has underscored several times in the past year, we need to get rid of the clericalism that shelters priests and bishops from being accountable to the whole church. You leaders in our parishes, help us. Please help us. Bishop Ryan and I, and all our priests and deacons, give your help. Lay people lead the church today. And it's true, we bishops and priests, deacons and religious, we have a place in the leadership of the church. But you are the vast majority. And if in every diocese there are people like you, you are leading the church to holiness. I desire that all in church leadership, and particularly my brothers, our priests, will find a renewed call to service, love, and holiness. I believe prayer, humility, and truth will bring even more healing. And though I mentioned about earlier afternoon about the failure can tell you that the majority of our priests, as the ones are with you tonight, and all the rest of them in the archdiocese, are good priests, faithful priests. I would like, at this point, to recognize the role of our priests in the development of the lay people into holiness. Brother priest, please stand. Showing us a way to follow her beloved Son, be with you, and in a way that only she can do, show you the tenderness of God, the kindness of God, the mercy of God. Dear Lady, help us all to bring the light of Christ into the world. Nos reunimos esta tarde para celebrar la luz de la fe que brilla en aquellos a quienes honramos con los premios Lumen Gentium y Christi Fidelis Laici. El Lumen Gentium, traducido significa luz de las naciones, y Christi Fidelis Laici se traduce como el pueblo fiel de Cristo. Estos dos awards premios expresan y afirman el papel y la responsabilidad de ustedes laicos que brota de su bautismo, de escuchar la voz de Dios y de responder a ella en sus comunidades. diciéndole al Señor, aquí estoy para hacer tu voluntad. Ustedes son aquellos que nos ayudan a todo el resto de la iglesia, y sobre todo a sacerdotes, diáconos y a laicos que son líderes, nos ayudan a continuar la labor de juntos construir nuestras comunidades de fe. Nuestra carta a los Hebreos nos recuerda que Jesús, nuestro sumo sacerdote, es completamente humano y divino, que se hizo hombre y que nos ayudó a reconocer nuestra debilidad, nuestra miseria, nuestra limitación, nuestro pecado. Y Él, que surge victorioso y glorioso como la luz del mundo, ha hecho posible que cada uno de ustedes se convierta en luz del mundo también. Y que así la misericordia, la compasión y el amor de Dios llegue a cada uno, a todos sin excepción. Estamos llamados y necesitamos mucho ser luz de Cristo en una densa oscuridad en nuestro mundo actual y también en la iglesia. Ya un poco antes de esta tarde expresé en nombre de todos ustedes pues esa parte oscura o una parte oscura de nuestra iglesia, el abuso sexual de menores por parte de sacerdotes y el cover up de obispos. Este tema es muy difícil y ha causado tristeza, indignación, confusión y desaliento en miembros de la iglesia. Y hemos vivido en esto más de 30 años. Sin embargo, estamos trabajando arduamente para brindar luz y transparencia, el tratar de brindar restauración y reconciliación a todos aquellos que han sido afectados por estos actos pecaminosos y criminales. Es muy claro que todos debemos de trabajar juntos como cuerpo de Cristo para hacer que la iglesia sea segura para todos, y no solo lo del abuso sexual, en otras cosas, en otros momentos, en otros encuentros, que podamos vivir bien y de acuerdo a la voluntad de Dios y caminar en la santidad, la cual ustedes reflejen. Necesitamos reconocer que sí, somos un pueblo pecador, pero en constante necesidad de conversión, reforma y renovación. Como el Papa Francisco ha subrayado varias veces en este último año, debemos deshacernos del clericalismo que escuda a los sacerdotes y obispos de rendir cuentas ante toda la iglesia. Deseo a todos los líderes de la iglesia, a ustedes laicos, en esta noche premiados, pero también a nuestros sacerdotes, a nuestros diáconos, a religiosos y religiosas, que encuentren en su llamado una renovación al servicio, al amor y a la santidad. Estoy convencido que la sanación vendrá a todos y a todas con oración, humildad y verdad. Al igual que el Señor resucitado, el buen pastor, necesitamos extender nuestra mano sanadora a todos aquellos que han sido dañados en nuestra iglesia. Ya lo expresé esta tarde en nombre de todos ustedes, pero ustedes que conocen a sus comunidades, ustedes que son luz en sus comunidades, que su luz no solamente ilumine, que su luz caliente, con amistad, con cariño, con ternura, esas situaciones difíciles en sus comunidades. Hemos reconocido a los sacerdotes, y en un momento dado reconocí a un laico, y en un momento a todos ustedes. Ustedes son la gran mayoría. En ustedes, el Señor nos está diciendo que necesitamos escucharnos, necesitamos seguirnos. Que el Señor les conceda ser luz en nuestra iglesia y para todas las naciones. Aquellos de ustedes que van a recibir premios esta noche son un maravilloso don e inspiración para todos nosotros sobre el discipulado misionero fiel. Ustedes nos ayudan al obispo Mike y a su servidor a que nos mantengamos fieles en nuestra vocación y en nuestro servicio a las comunidades. Gracias por su testimonio. Nuestra Señora siempre está con nosotros. La Virgen de Guadalupe, la Morenita, la Guadalupana, ella nos muestra el camino para seguir a su amado Jesús. Querida Señora, ayúdanos a llevar la luz de Cristo al mundo. Gracias por ser uno con la Iglesia local de San Antonio en sus tinieblas o en los misterios dolorosos. Y muchas, muchas gracias, y aún más, por ser también luz y misterios gloriosos para nuestra comunidad católica de San Juan. Gracias. Thank you. May God bless you.
The Parish Lumen Gentium Award is bestowed upon Catholic lay people from each parish who have demonstrated participation in the Catholic Church's mission to bring Christ's light to all. The individual is a practicing Catholic who manifests an understanding of the teachings of the Church and has been graced with a life formed in the Catholic spiritual tradition. The individual has used his or her talents to deepen the life of the church in the parish, or has served in extraordinary ways the ministry of the parish. From Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin Mary at St. Hedwig, Laurie Johnson. From the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Little Flower in San Antonio, Gavin Sanchez. From Blessed Sacrament at Poff, Lawrence Jansky. From Blessed Sacrament in San Antonio, Lillian De Luna. From Christ the King in San Antonio, Connie Vargas. From the Church of the Holy Spirit in San Antonio, Letty Spain. From Divine Providence in San Antonio, Paloma Gori. From Good Shepherd in Shirts, Charlie Espinosa. From Holy Cross at the Hannes, Tammy Posa. From Holy Family in New Braunfels, Rosalinda Young. From Holy Family in San Antonio, Victoria Alonso. From Holy Name in San Antonio, Miguel and Diana Cuba. From Holy Redeemer in San Antonio, Shirley Ellis. From Holy Rosary in San Antonio, Jamie Ubando. From Holy Trinity in Falls City, Patsy Secula. From Holy Trinity in San Antonio, Michael and Veronica Bonkin. From Immaculate Conception in Lytle, Alfredo and Carol Aguilar. receptionist Antonio, Moses Barrientos. From Immaculate Conception in shirts, Joyce de Pizera. From Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary in Panama Maria, Elaine Dolores Montigano. From Immaculate Heart of Mary in Pearsall, Tomasa C. Ramirez. From Immaculate Heart of Mary in San Antonio, Harvey and Maria Garland. From Immaculate Heart of Mary, Yancy and Johannes, Burry Fence. From Mary Queen of the Universe in Comstock, Maria, Bill G. and Aileen Moses. From Mission Concepcion in San Antonio, Nathan and Rosemary Suniga. From Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Chistahoa in Fall City, Aileen Jenkins. From Dora Day in Kerbal, Mark Innes. From Our Lady of Council in San Antonio, Gregoria Chavarria. From Our Lady of Grace in San Antonio, Al and April Zardowski. From Our Lady of Guadalupe in Fredericksburg, Simon and Luz Maria Cuevas. From Our Lady of Guadalupe in Colores, Cindy Ferguson. From Our Lady of Guadalupe in San Antonio, Maria Flores. Our Lady of Guadalupe, Seguin, Gilbert, and Dolores Avalos. From Our Lady of Mount Carmel in San Antonio, Kenneth R. and Maria Celia Albrecht. From Our Lady of Mount Carmel in Divine, Ricardo Moreno. From Our Lady of Perpetual Health in San Antonio, Blanche Mora. From Our Lady of Perpetual Health in Selma, Carlos and Ruth Salinas. From Our Lady of Perpetual Health, Sespanto Elmender, Matthew Lagas. From Our Lady of Sorrows in San Antonio, Eva Lopez. From Our Lady of the Angels in San Antonio, Tommy Pooh Hewitt. From Sacred Heart,
from the Sacred Heart of San Antonio, Margarita Flores. San Fernando Cathedral in San Antonio, Robert and Debbie Ruiz. from St. Anthony in Harbor, Arthur H. and Cynthia A. Hansen.
From St. Gabriel in San Antonio,
Ivan Martinez. From St. George Jeremy in San Antonio, Marie Salem. St. Gregory the Great in San Antonio, Michael and Roberta Urrutia. St. Helena in San Antonio, Hector Mayer. St. Joseph and Kilden. from St. Joseph, downtown San Antonio, Gloria Gonzalez. Patrick Miller from Gonzales, Jamie Mitchell.
is bestowed upon a Catholic couple who have demonstrated by participation in parish life the personal and ministerial renewal called for by the papal exhortation Christi Fidelis Laici, calling the lady to the vocation of responsibility for the Church's life springing from the gift and mission of their baptism. Archbishop Gustavo Garcia Siller himself chooses the recipient of the Christi Fidelis Award. This year's awardees are Ruben and Veronica Escobar.
was presented in the temple. Let us adore him as we say.
Jesus Christ, living
Jesus, Cristo Salvador, tú que eres la luz para alumbrar las naciones, ilumina a los que aún te desconocen y haz que crean en ti, Dios verdadero. You are the Redeemer and the glory of your people Israel. May your church proclaim your salvation to the ends of the earth. Señor Jesucristo, deseado de todos los pueblos y contemplado por los ojos del justo Simeón, haz que todos los hombres puedan alcanzar tu salvación. Lord, when you were presented in the temple, Simeon foretold that a sword of sorrow would pierce your mother's heart. Strengthen us to accept the sufferings we endure for the sake of your name.
Jesus Christ,
Cristo, felicidad de los santos, a quien Simeón pudo contemplar antes de la muerte, como tanto había deseado. Haz que los difuntos que desean contemplar tu rostro se sacien de tu visión. Jesus, you are the protector of the little ones, for the kingdom of God is theirs. Help your church to be a place where children are safe and well cared for as they learn of your love and the greatness of heaven.
Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus, escucha us.
All-powerful Father, Christ, and now let us pray with confidence as Christ our Lord asked.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
because your faith is proclaimed in all the world. all imagine that we have other people to thank for this evening, it takes the collaboration of so many individuals and groups. The liturgy office takes care of preparing the worship aids, and the office for clergy worked very diligently in collecting the nominees and arranging all the fine details. Martha Ross got thanked, but we should thank her again, I think.
Thank you.